Geo character is coming up, and then I'm playing it again because of this. So let's watch this.
Greetings, travelers. Welcome to the Genshin Impact version 2.3 special program. I'm one of your hosts, Zach Aguilar, and I voice the male traveler Ether in Genshin Impact. And today I'm joined by...
Hi everybody, I'm Corey Yi, and I voice Goro in Genshin Impact.
Yeah,
General
I know Noelle.
Goro of the Watatsumi Island Resistance, well,
Noelle's pretty
ready
strong.
And waiting. Nice. And our other host for today is Koi.
Hey Albedo. There, I'm Koi Dao.
I play. Yo, they're bringing out a Geo, man.
Chief Alchemist of the Knights of Favonius, as you can see from my
the MC Geo MC,
which is super adorable, by the way. My, it certainly is lively outside of the workshop.
Welcome to the special program, guys. Are you too excited?
Yeah, man. Like, Genshin is my favorite game right now.
This is like 40
so
minutes
I'm just excited
long,
to talk about the details of Goro.
Well, I'm just super glad to be included. Haven't done one of these before, but been wanting to, because look at my teeny tiny little chibi body. I am so adorable.
As always, we'll be doing previews for the upcoming content in version 2.3. You guys ready?
Oh, I am so ready.
Let's do it, man.
All right. Let's start by jumping right into the version trailer. Shadows.
Damn, it's trending number 8.
Snowstorms.
Nice.
That's a lot of S's.
That's a lot of S's. Okay.
With this newfound strength, I will defend those who fight alongside me. Protecting my soldiers doesn't
Goro.
Just mean having a robust defense in place. It means going on the attack. The key to seizing victory in battle lies in remembering the meaning of battle and employing the right tactics to generate momentum. Pull in! Keep your weapon at
the
ready. The
canine warrior.
You never know what's around the corner.
This is Angenshin. I just do dailies and love out.
An Oni.
An Oni. Did you just summon a field?
Arataki, so. We've been trying to apprehend him recently.
People see Oni cause trouble again. That'll defeat the whole purpose of the sacrifice he made.
Save the boss battle for later.
He won't get away this time. Just give yourself
Ito.
A long time ago, I picked up this rare paper charm. It's very precious to me. When it gets torn, this place goes up in smoke!
Ah, that idiot Oni. What did you say, little one? Go on, say it to my face.
Say it to my face. He's like, say it to my face.
Man,
damn, oh, did he just summon a... bull?
Oh, coming through! Step aside, Ito's back in town.
Ooh.
Had fun. Now it's goodbye.
Shut up, would ya?
Oh, does he punches at his ult?
The transcendent and miraculous are not the only things to which human
That'd
beings
be
aspire.
Like,
they pursue the everyday, the ordinary, to a far greater extent than I would have ever imagined. This mountain we stand on is a cradle of life's profoundest mysteries, a vast, terrifying hotbed of possibilities.
People are put off by the cold and don't realize that there is much to explore beneath the icy exterior.
Oh? Are you here to build a snowman too?
Maybe a
Let's
snowman.
Combine our forces and build ourselves a huge snowman. It'll be a ton of fun.
What's on your mind? You seem a little distracted.
Some of my alchemy notes are missing. We do not yet know the identity of our thief. Please take care.
Dragonspine has
back
become
to Dragonspine?
More dangerous than it used to be.
Oh, we're gonna end up going back to Dragonspine?
Oh no! Avalanche!
Albedo, what the devil do you think you were doing?
What? When did Albedo get trial powers? What the heck? What's going on? Oh, Albedo is turning, his whatever form coming out. Oh my god.
I like the snake puppy.
Super cool to see Albedo and Eula in Dragonspine.
Yeah. Like, I don't know what's going on there, but it looks pretty tense. Also, can we please talk about Bennett looking amazing? That was
I know, right?
Like one of my favorite parts, to be honest.
I know Bennett. We probably can't wait to learn more about the all new content we just saw, but before we dive in, let's
we skipping this,
first
right?
Redemption
yeah.
code.
We don't need that. I already got the redemption code. Let me, Oh, I missed it. Okay. Ito. Abs. Oh, that's his idol stance? He combs his hair. And he summons a bull. Ooh. Oh, you just keep attacking? Oh, I like this part.
Probably. Beetle fighting, trading card games, spinning tops, kendama, hide and seek, you name it, I can play it. What do you say?
Oh, he's a gamer. Have a little contest? Yo, he's a gamer.
Just make sure you're ready to get thrashed.
Whoa.
Did you see him swing his claymore and then fix his hair?
He's
like
so
the
stylish.
Coolest dude in Inazuma.
And yet he's like kind of this goofy kid at the same time. Like,
that's like me,
like
man.
Like hearing his words, it's so interesting, that dynamic, but I'm into it.
I like to fix
okay,
my hair.
So our first character to introduce is Arataki Ito. As
yo,
you
what's
can
up?
Probably tell from the horns on
watching
his head,
some Genshin
this guy is definitely
2.3 right now doing Revenge.
That's right. In fact, Ito's horns are a symbol of his Oni heritage. Just like the Adepti
Oni,
Mire,
he's the Oni.
Oni are a special kind of being in Inazuma. We have already encountered other special
Oni
beings
fans.
In our previous adventures across Inazuma, such as the Bake Danuki and Tengu. This time, we are adding Oni to the list. Aside from
oh,
Ito's
really?
Heritage, his unique
nice.
Charisma has also attracted all kinds of followers to him. Word on the streets is that Ito
I'm like
has
super
established
late.
His own crew. Called the Arataki Gang.
Okay, so he's a gang leader. That's an interesting twist.
Yeah, but he's not quite the kind you might be thinking of. There have been some interesting stories about Ito floating
time,
around.
Time to get abs and cosplay as him, right?
He's the big guy with the horns that would play cards with kids to win all of their snacks from them.
Absolutely.
Damn.
That sounds like a kid's worst nightmare.
And apparently, he also won a ramen eating contest
Yo,
against
I'm hungry.
A certain fox-eared lady.
Right, which is another aspect of his character. He has a strong will to win no matter what he's doing.
Yeah, that makes sense. So it probably explains why we see his rematch challenge to Kujo Sara on the Hanamizaka bulletin board. Oh, Sara's the one who defeated him and confiscated his vision under the Vision Hunt decree.
Well,
oh.
enough of us just talking about him. Why don't we let
don't
Ito himself
that.
Introduce his combat skills?
Oh, combat
Let's
skills.
Let's welcome our special correspondent, voice of Arataki Ito. Max Middleman
taking it to the max.
Hey, can you hear me? Check 1 2 3. Arataki numero uno Ito here in the flesh. So what are we doing, talking about Ito's fighting style? Cool. Let's get into it. Ito wields a claymore and manipulates the geo element.
Geo.
He's strong, tough, reliable, a true Oni horn to toe. His normal attack performs up to 4 consecutive strikes, and when his second and fourth attacks hit opponents, Ito will gain stacks of superlative super strength. Pretty cool name, huh? Oh, another thing to note is that Ito's normal attack combo won't reset for a short time after using his elemental skill or performing a sprint, which means you can keep on swinging even
Damn.
After you move. When you hold to initiate
swinging.
A charged attack, you can use superlative strength stacks to perform Arataki Kesagiri slashes without spending any stamina.
Oh.
Each Arataki Kesagiri slash will consume 1 stack of superlative super strength. When the final stack is consumed, Ito will unleash an especially powerful attack.
The jump pound?
When no stacks yeah. of superlative super strength are available, Ito will perform a Saichi Monji slash. Oh, and most importantly,
Damn
remember
us.
To keep your hairstyle as cool as possible. Even when the wind keeps trying to mess it up.
Always.
After unlocking the talent Arataki Ichiban, which, by the way, means Ito
run,
is the best.
I run to battle.
When Ito uses consecutive Arataki Kesagiri,
oh,
his
Saitama?
Resistance to interruption greatly increases, and each slash causes
Persona
the subsequent
5,
slash to have higher attack speed. So your slashes will keep getting faster and harder to stop. With another one
Damn.
Of Ito's talents,
yeah.
Bloodline of the Crimson Oni, damage of Ito's Arataki Kesagiri is increased by a certain percentage of Ito's defense. When using his elemental skill, Ito hurls
defense
Ushi,
build.
The young Akaushi bull, at opponents, dealing geo damage. When Ushi hits opponents, it'll grant Ito 1 stack of superlative super strength. Ushi also happens to be an auxiliary member of the Arataki gang. Aw, isn't it cute? Anyway, Ushi is considered a geoconstruct, and it'll remain on the field to taunt surrounding opponents and draw their attacks.
And Zhongli
won't stick around forever. It'll flee when its HP drops to zero or its duration ends. Ushi also grants Ito one stack of superlative super strength when it takes damage and when it leaves.
Oh man.
Next up, let's talk about Ito's Oni King form. After unleashing his elemental burst, Royal Descent, behold Ito the Evil, Ito lets his inner raging Oni King emerge, using his Oni King's Kanabo in battle. Yeah, you see that mace he's swinging? During this state, Ito's normal, charged, and plunging attacks will be converted to geo damage that cannot be overridden.
Oh,
the first
geo
and
damage.
Third combos of his normal attack will grant Arataki Ito himself one stack of superlative.
Wait, do I
want to
use him
opponents.
As a physical kind of?
While in Raging Oni King state, Ito's
like,
elemental and physical resistance drop,
no,
but
not, huh?
His attack will be increased based on his defense, and his normal attack speed will also be increased. Ito
defense,
also has an exploration talent. Woodchuck chucked. When we have Ito in our party, we will have a chance to obtain an additional log of wood while using attacks.
I have
to
no
collect
I barely have any
tree.
Wood, so that's good
so,
for me.
Collecting wood materials will be more efficient. Ito's pretty slick,
good
huh?
Deal.
Anyway, I'm looking forward to seeing everyone interact with Ito.
What's
in
his cooldown for his
he's honestly a really fun character to voice. And those are all the inside deets about the one and only Arataki Ito. Zach, throwing it back to you.
And that's all from our special correspondent, Max Middleman. Thanks, Max.
Thanks, Max.
Bye, guys.
Guess that was okay, Max. Just kidding.
Damn.
He looks like such a cool character, though. Like, he's got really interesting combos and stacking. And, like, I don't know. That just seems really cool to play.
Totally. Next, we're moving on to our other new playable character in version 2.3. Let's see him in action.
Oh, Goro? Oh, what's that? What's that? Oh, from fish message. Oh, wait, what's that flag do though? That's a big area.
If there's anything ever troubling you, don't keep it all muzzled up inside. You can always speak your mind with me. Although I can't guarantee that I'll always have an answer, I'll certainly offer you my best advice. Even when I can't muster much of a response, you can always count on me to be a good listener. Whatever it is, I'm all ears.
All ears, I get it.
Whoa, here we go.
He looks like a real good boy with a big, beautiful heart.
That he does.
I like him.
So, I know what everybody's wondering. Can we pet his ears?
Oh my goodness. Well, that might be a little awkward, but if anyone could pet Goro, it'd probably be the Traveler. Not you, Zach, but the Traveler.
He wants some pets!
Just to be clear.
I would like to scratch Goro behind the ears.
Oh my gosh.
What?
Everybody is so goofy. Yeah.
Anyways, with all that being said, although Goro looks really young, he's one of the most reliable characters you might ever meet.
Yeah, in fact, among the ones at Sumi Island Resistance, he's known as Top Dog Goro.
Right, which is interesting because Goro is still younger than most of his fellow officers. He earned the nickname because he's close with his troops, and the other officers are always lining up asking him for advice. And to be completely honest, Goro often doesn't know the right advice to give either. But he can't let the soldiers down, so he just gives some general pointers and responds based on his own gut feelings, which has worked pretty well, so everyone sees him as reliable.
Yeah, you know, I guess that's what happens when you wear your heart on your sleeve.
But as soon as he returns to the battlefield, Goro is back to his serious general self, ready to lead the troops. Although, because Goro is still young and inexperienced, his temper can sometimes get the best of him. Anyway, let's take a look at how he fights.
Yeah.
General Goro of the Watatsumi Island Resistance wields a bow and holds a geovision. His elemental skill, Inuzaka All-Round Defense, deals AoE
defense.
Geo damage and sets up his general's war banner.
Aw, the dog pond, the banner is so cute.
I love it.
Thanks, guys. Well, this banner is more than just for show. It provides buffs to active characters within the ability's AoE based on the number of party members in field who are of the Geo element. So, for example, when we have one Geo party member, it grants a defense bonus. When we have two Geo party members, in addition to the defense bonus, it increases resistance to interruption. And when we have three Geo party members, it adds a Geo damage bonus on top of the previous two bonuses we just mentioned.
Okay, so what you're saying is the more Geo characters we have in our party, like, I don't know, Albedo, the more buffs we gain from Goro's elemental skill?
Yes, that is correct. Any characters who lack defense in Geo, and there's a few of them, would probably like that a lot.
Yes.
And finally, we...
Noelle.
Thanks, Koi.
Noelle too, man.
And finally, we have Goro's elemental burst, Juga Forward Unto Victory. Unleashing his burst, Goro deals AoE Geo damage and creates a field known as General's Glory. Just like his elemental skill, the field provides buffs to active characters according to the number of Geo party members. What's special about this field is that it moves together with your active character and periodically generates a Crystal Collapse, which deals AoE Geo damage to one opponent within its AoE. After unlocking the talent Heedless of the Wind and Weather, Goro's elemental burst also increases all party members' defense. And another one of Goro's talents, a favor repaid, grants damage bonuses to Goro's elemental skill and elemental burst based on his defense, which is great.
Everyone throwing defense.
Seeing characters using different stats.
Wow, so that's all really cool. But I have to admit, that little sidekick of his is so cute. Look at how it waves its banner alongside Goro.
I want to be its friend.
Okay, guys, focus. Come on.
I will be its friend.
I will.
So, aside from his combat-related talents, Goro also has a pretty useful exploration talent called Seeker of Shinies.
Seeker
yes.
Of what?
Shinies?
Seeker of Shinies.
The shiny.
It's amazing and it's adorable. Yes, I totally understand that. This talent displays the location of nearby resources unique to Inazuma on the minimap while you have Goro in your party.
Hmm. Oh my goodness, let's go seek some shinies. It's going to be so handy when we're farming materials in Inazuma.
Totally.
Yeah, so you guys like Goro? Sound pretty good?
Yes.
Very good. A very good boy.
A very, very good boy.
I knew that's where it was going, and I'm just not disappointed.
Well, all right, now that we've had our first look at our new
artifacts
characters,
review.
Let's check out the event wishes coming in version 2.3.
All right, the banner.
The event wishes for version 2.3 are going to be a little different from previous versions.
Damn, 2 5
this
stars.
This time, we will be opening two character event wishes at the same time during the earlier phase of version 2.3.
Oh, both at the same time.
Albedo's Secretum Secretorum.
The different banners.
And Eula's Born of Ocean Swell.
Okay, so both Albedo and Eula's rerun will be available at the same time, that means.
Oh.
That's cool. What
Sounds
else we got?
Cool, yeah. Well, also in the later phase of version 2.3,
this is what we're going for, right?
Wish
I'm
going to
skip Albedo. I have Albedo.
Two
C1.
New characters, Arataki Ito and Goro.
I'm guessing many of our viewers might be curious about the first two rerun event wishes, so why don't we give some more details?
Oh, yeah, for sure. With each version update, we've met many new companions on our journey, so some new players might want to get limited characters from previous event wishes, but it's probably going to take a long time before they see their favorite character return. After collecting and considering player feedback, the devs have decided to push reruns forward when the timing fits the version content.
So, coming back to the two concurrent character event wishes in version 2.3, both will actually share the same cumulative pull count toward the 5-star drop guarantee.
Okay.
Which means any pulls
what
you
about
make
the four
on
star?
One
no
of
four
the character
stars?
Event wishes will also count towards the other. So, for example, if you pulled 50 times on Albedo's Secretum Secretorum and didn't gain a single 5-star character, then you are still guaranteed to gain at least one 5-star character in the remaining 40 pulls on Eula's Born of Ocean Swell. There will be more information in an upcoming.
Like, if you want the four stars for one of them, you pull on that, and then you switch.
And
you
as
want the
expected,
five star
with new characters comes new storylines. Ito's story quest, Taurus Iracundus, will be added in the new version for travelers to explore. The Oni race once left countless figures in Inazuman Legends, but how do Ito or other Oni live in the current Inazuma? For any players interested in diving deeper into Ito's backstory, this story quest will be a great place to start.
Sounds swell to me.
In addition to Ito's story quest, both Goro and Beto will be receiving their very own hangout events in version 2.3.
That's right. Players are going to get an inside look at some of the secrets behind General Goro.
Watching some Genshin.
Oh, and 2.3,
I haven't watched.
Captain Beto for an all-new adventure in her hangout as well.
We have quite a few new storylines awaiting travelers in the new
version. I have an event right now that I need to
do. Some story keys to unlock those.
Heck yeah. If you like new characters and storylines, I bet you'll like some new weapons and artifacts in version 2.3. The new 5-star Claymore Redhorn Stonecrusher will be appearing in
character
one of
with curiosity effect when a field gains one stack after hitting an opponent with a heal attack, triggering maximum one.
Ocean Hued Clam will become available in the new version.
Off field
players will be able to
gain
these artifacts.
Bonus. Oh yeah, I remember seeing this.
Located on Seirai Island in Inazuma.
I'm gonna be farming a lot of artifacts.
Been clamoring for new artifacts and new artifacts.
The weapon banner too.
Possibilities for characters and great party combinations.
Yeah, for sure.
Slaying your team.
Now that we've covered all the new equipment coming our way, we're ready to see a new deadly boss rising in the coming version. Let's take a look at the Golden Wolf Lord.
Need that for Ito. He's gonna be immune to Geo or what? Or resistant to Geo? Boom. Oh, you gotta shoot the thingies and hit, you know, hit the...
And that's our new open world boss, the Golden Wolf Lord.
Dude.
Whoa, spicy puppy snake. I love him.
I'm kind of grappling with, like, wanting to fight it and wanting to pet it. I don't really know
what I'm going to make it my Golden Wolf friend.
What's up, man? Oh,
did you guys see the tornado, too? I'm like, oh, I better not get hit with that thing.
Yeah, seeing that just made me feel winded.
Also, the size of that thing—that's one giant rift hound.
Yeah, now that you mention it, the structures of their bodies look really similar.
What's up, man?
Great observation.
I'm just watching some Genshin right now.
Technically, the Golden Wolf Lord is the king of the Rift Wolves, which is also the reason why Rift Hounds and Rift Hound Whelps appeared in Tsurumi Island in the first place.
Damn.
As a giant, monstrous beast from another world, its subjects are tasked with making preparations before it descends. And since this monster will be a recurring boss in Tsurumi Island, players will be able to challenge this abyssal beast at any time.
Okay, challenge accepted.
Which island is that? Is that new island?
Well, let's give everyone the inside scoop. In combat, the Golden Wolf Lord's attacks can apply stacks of the corrosion status, which will cause all characters in the party to continuously lose HP. When the Wolf Lord's HP drops to a certain threshold, it will summon Rift Hound Alphas to provide it with shields.
Well, that just doesn't sound fair.
I mean, I think I'm up for this fight, but it does sound pretty tough.
Yeah, but don't worry. In the latter stage of the fight, the Wolf Lord's resistance to Geo attacks decreases, while its attack increases. So you'll have to factor that into your strategy.
I gotta do math? Okay, is there anything else I should know?
Nope, I think that's about all we have for this new monster.
All right, it's probably a good time to take a short break and give away our second redemption code.
Sounds good.
All right, code inbound in.
Tales on the new events coming in version 2.3.
Cinnabar Spindle.
This time we're returning to the Snowy Dragon Spine area to explore an all-new event. Koi, I know that you know a thing or two about Dragon Spine, so why don't you take the lead?
It would be my pleasure, Zach. Okay. The main event in version 2.3 is called Shadows Amid Snowstorms. In this event,
what about the other dragon spine sword? Dragon spine.
They plan to have seasoned adventurers pairing up with newer recruits. Some of our old friends from Mondstadt will be joining to help out too. You know, like Amber and Eula.
That's cool. You see what I did there? Cool, because it's cold and
yes, Zach,
spine.
I did see what you did there.
Well, we'll definitely need our friends to survive the deadly cold of Dragonspine.
Yep. Travelers who've reached Adventure Rank 20 and completed the prerequisite quests will be able to participate in the event. And you know, outside the event storylines,
and it does even more
thing
damage.
Oh
my
various
god!
Challenges and earn
yeah, I mean, I'll probably
switch
swords.
For a range
give the old sword to maybe Bennett.
I decided to chill in Dragonspine again, but what kinds of gameplay can we expect for travelers during our winter training?
The first is called agility training. Basically, it's a special speed training. Once you start, you need to follow the guides to proceed down a race course. The goal is to get the highest score possible before successfully reaching the end. And your score is based on the amount of time spent and the number of insignias of adventure and insignias of conquest you're able to collect during the training.
Ooh, and it also looks like we've got some special buffs to make use of.
That is correct. Special blessings will sometimes appear while you race. There are two kinds of blessings.
Can you do in co-op, though?
First is the Gale Spring blessing, which will enhance your character's jumping abilities.
And have them, like, you know, apply to them, too.
Blessing, which will allow your characters to shatter ice pillars around them.
Okay, okay, so we'll need to aim for the ice pillars containing insignias once we have this blessing.
Oh, you are so smart. That is correct. Travelers should be sure to make use of it. Some insignias of adventure will be hidden in the course, but insignias of conquest appear only at certain times. Ooh. You'll need to get the correct timing down and grab them throughout the challenge. Second type of gameplay
specific
is
time,
tracker
huh?
training. Travelers will need to find and melt all the ice crystal piles within the training area to complete the challenge.
God damn it, I gotta run fire units.
Character is gonna be a must for your party in this.
God damn it.
Yep, yep. But this training shouldn't be too much of a problem. We just need to be careful of the nearby enemies and surrounding environment. And our third type of gameplay is combat training.
Ooh, combat. The favorite one.
Favorite part, yeah.
Combat training camps will contain lures that can be activated to begin the training session. Lures will start in a state of source cold and will emanate cold air that not only increases the rate at which sheer cold will accumulate on your
character.
Yeah,
if you have any questions, I'll be down to
answer. Also gives nearby opponents a buff at fixed intervals.
Sounds like this one might be a little more intense for challengers then.
Yeah, we have a Genshin channel.
There are multiple mechanisms around the lures. Travelers can activate these mechanisms by attacking them while carrying Scarlet Quartz. Once you've activated the three mechanisms, they will change the lure state to heat source and cancel the accumulation of sheer cold. Yeah, see? When lures switch to heat source mode, characters will also restore a certain amount of energy at fixed intervals. So on heat source mode, dealing damage to opponents while carrying Scarlet Quartz will unleash all the quartz energy in a single blow, dealing AoE pyro damage to the opponents.
I can already see myself searching frantically to find Scarlet Quartz in this one.
Goddamn.
Yeah, but actually, besides looking for Scarlet Quartz in the surrounding area, you can also obtain Scarlet Quartz by defeating certain monsters during the challenge. All three of these trainings have multiple challenges.
What if I do without
the
sword?
Completed to obtain event currencies, primo gems, and mora. You can also obtain some snowman components from the tracker training and combat training.
Dude, the snowman. That's a nice seasonal touch.
Yeah, I
love Christmas coming up, guys.
On Dragon's Spine.
But Thanksgiving's on first.
Participate in the event to collect components, which can be used to build snowmen in-game. Travelers can also exchange some of their components with their friends.
Oh, hey, we're all friends. Why don't we
perceivably
build them together?
We could build snowmen. I'd be down.
Yeah.
That is very exciting. And to add to the excitement, players will be able to claim rewards by building snowmen, including a new 4-star sword.
Yeah, that sword,
Cinnabar
right?
Spindle.
Oh, it's 4-star? Yeah. I was like, is it going to be a 5-star?
Refine this bad boy? Well, you can collect event currencies and exchange them for the sword's refinement materials via the event shop.
So, I'm sure players are wondering, can we keep our snowmen after the event's over?
Absolutely. We can bring the snowmen bases and components home after the whole
thing
wraps up.
All right, another decoration for our Serena teapot. I'm looking forward to checking out all the snowman styles.
Oh, yeah, me too. But you know what? Aside from all the winter training events, we'll also encounter a mysterious boss once we get further into the event story. But
the co-op
travelers
boss?
Will probably have to discover that for themselves.
Can it be a co-op boss?
Anyway, I'm super excited for this event. Are you guys excited?
Yeah. And it sounds like we'll have a ton of seasonal things to do on
Dragon's Fire. Oh, I see why they drive
by
Christmas.
Next, we'll be heading back to Inazuma for our next event titled Bantan Sango Case Files, The Warrior Dog.
Warrior Dog?
Wait, what?
What was that?
Was that you, Koi?
No, it was Corey.
You can't blame this one on the dog.
Okay, anyway, back to our event. There have been mysterious disappearances of animals across Inazuma lately. And of course, the Traveler is there to help. According to the commission, our objective is to find and bring the missing animals back. During investigation, we get to find a mysterious dog which patrols around some of the missing animals.
Well, a dog? There's like a whole bunch of dogs here.
These are all its canine bunshin, which are like illusionary copies.
Oh yeah, these aren't your average guard dog. They're carrying a little sword.
That's why we need to sneak to where the dog keeps the little animals and avoid being detected, unless we want to be attacked.
That, sir, sounds super scary.
Yes, it does.
Just put on shield.
In this event, travelers will obtain a gadget called the Ubiquity Net. Travelers can use it to replace their elemental skill with the net's ability. We'll use this ability on the indicated animals to whisk them away. If the skill hits a canine bunshin, it will be stunned for a short time. Travelers can also activate smoke machines and fireworks around places of interest to cause distractions, too. Throughout our investigation, we'll also discover numbers of animals that have been kept in cages inside places called dens of thieves. We'll need to defeat the surrounding opponents first before opening the cages and coming to their rescue. By completing
like
event
Sonic,
challenges,
you know, when you
we
have
can
those,
claim rewards
animals in those machines.
Gems, so be sure to give it a
you
try.
You gotta break the
after
machines to save the
ends,
animals.
Travelers can complete the related world requests to obtain a brand new gadget called the Omni Ubiquity Net.
That's quite a name.
Yeah. Ubiquity. Unlike the gadget from the event, this upgraded net has been modified using Onmyodo. It is said it can capture the essence of smaller creatures before using the net itself as a medium to replicate their forms.
Oh, you know those random foxes
so
that you hit? Or cats?
We can keep pets with it.
Well, sort of. We can use the net as a way of recreating animals that we meet in the open world and place them in our Serenity Pot.
But the bottom line is, I can be like Draft or Timmy and have an army of pigeons at my disposal.
I will accept this.
Right. But please note that there are some little critters who cannot be recreated using the net.
Like geckos?
Travelers may find which animals can be recreated in the archive.
Yes, we're gonna get to keep some more animals in our realms.
Our next event is Energy Amplifier Fruition. Some of you may remember the previous Energy Amplifier event. It turns out that after our previous research, some remaining mutation stones have started to surface.
I don't remember this energy amplifier event.
Travelers will need to get to the places of interest and eliminate threats there.
But mutation stones can grant powerful bonuses to opponents, so we'll want to take care of those first before facing the enemy.
Yeah. After defeating the enemies, we can open the chests to claim rewards. What's different from the previous energy amplifier event is that once travelers have cleared all the investigation tasks in Act 1, they'll automatically gain the energy amplifier and all of the Earman Soul fruit fragments. Each act cleared will unlock the corresponding deceitful domain.
And just like the previous time we entered this event,
we'll be able to select
the difficulty and conditions for the domains we enter, and the energy amplifier will help amplify our
abilities
in these domains. The fragments you configure into the energy amplifier will determine the buffs you gain during the challenge.
In terms of rewards, there will be both first clear rewards and milestone score rewards to claim in this event, so you definitely don't want to miss out on those. Our next event to introduce is Misty Dungeon, Realm of Light.
Yeah, travelers may remember this one as well.
I remember this.
Just like our previous Misty Dungeon event, travelers will use the trial characters to complete dungeon trials. You will need to find all three of the ancient runes in the dungeon.
I use Noelle
and
Mona, and then Mona just go under the water everything.
Once all three runes are activated, travelers can gain access to the final challenge.
There are benediction mechanics with the trials, which allow players to obtain certain bonus effects.
At the same time, there are also some automated weapon systems that will detect and attack any intruders.
So travelers must use the appropriate reactions to temporarily disable these devices.
This time around, there will be new trial characters available and new trials for travelers to challenge. For example, in the Thundershock trial, Electrocharged will not only receive a damage bonus, but also increase the rate at which your elemental skills and bursts can be used.
Well, that sounds cool, and also super helpful for finding our way through all the enemies.
Definitely. And don't forget to finish as many trial quests as possible to claim more rewards. And speaking of recurring events, our most popular merchant, Lieben, is coming back in version 2.3 with his goods. Players can search for Lieben and submit the materials that he requests to claim rewards. And that's all we've got for the upcoming events.
Are they gonna do some quality of life changes
for version 2.3?
We sure did, and buckle up, cause there's more. We've got some details on a fun update to the Serenity Pot.
Right. After the Paimon version 2.3 update, we will be able to put Paimon into our Serenity Pot.
And she's got some new dialogue for us while she's in our teapot.
come and talk with Paimon whenever you have the chance.
I don't think that I want to, if that's what she sounds like, but I think I will take pictures with Paimon. It's not often we get to snap a photo with Paimon.
Okay. And that concludes the new version content for today.
That was a pretty good Paimon.
That it?
Rush.
As Zhongli says.
How was that?
So, Koi and Corey, you...
I mean, that's it, right?
You just die plenty of time.
All right.
I'm better.
I'm excited for new characters and for the special program today.
Thanks for watching the Genshin Impact version 2.3 special program.
They need better endgame, though, to be
honest. And we'll see you all in game.
Or more endgame stuff.
Bye.
Bye.